In this video, I'll break down 5 different approaches to sending automated emails from Airtable. We'll start with the most robust, high-volume option, SendGrid. But if that feels too complex, I'll show you a simpler, smaller-scale solution using Mailchimp. For those of you looking to send fewer plain text emails, I will also cover how you can use your own Gmail account or even Airtable's native email feature, which doesn't require any additional software. Finally, I will share you a simple trick to send emails using nothing more than just a formula. Let's get started. Hi, this is Greg from Business Automated, and on this channel, we help you save time and money by automating your business workflows. If you are new here, consider subscribing to get the latest updates or even joining our channel to get a wide range of membership-only perks. Let's start with SendGrid, which is great for high-volume transactional emails or marketing campaigns, but it requires a little bit more effort to set up. So let's start with the first step, which will be creating a new sender. Once you create a new sender over here, you will need to verify that you have a permission to send emails from this account. Then the next step will be creating an API key, which we'll be using in the next steps inside of Airtable. After you have this one done, we will move on to setting up a custom template inside of SendGrid. So you have to go to Dynamic Templates and click Create Dynamic Template. Once you have the template set up, inside of the template, you are able to personalize the template. And this is the important part, you can add tags for custom data personalization. So in this case, we're passing the name. Now let's move over to our Airtable. Inside of our Airtable, we have contacts with the name of the contacts and their email addresses. Then we have emails, which we'll be using to send specific emails to a specific person. And then we have email templates. And you'll notice that for every email template, we have a SendGrid template ID. This is the ID that you can find inside of your dynamic templates over here. So you can copy this template ID over here. And as you will see over here, what we will do, we will select a specific template. We will select template summer sale. And you will see that we are already having a lookup column from the contacts over here so that we have their email and their first name. So right now here, we would send a button to be sent. But before we do that, let's see what happens inside of the automation that we have set up to send out those emails. So over here, we have automation which reacts to this status to be sent. And inside of our automation, you will see that we have a code that takes basically 3 different variables, which is our name, email, and the template ID from the lookup values. I will share this script in the description of the video below, and you'll be able to reuse it once you personalize the API key and the messages that you are passing over here. And with this one done, you can see that after the script, we have one final module that updates status to sent. And once we go back over here, you can see that the status has changed from to be sent to sent. And this email to Jane has been sent out by SendGrid. And we can find this inside of our mailbox. So you can see this is the email that went to that specific person. And the name of the person was used instead of the placeholder. In the next example, we'll be using Mailchimp, which is great for sending regular newsletters and targeted conditional marketing emails. So when we go back to Airtable, we will move on to the contacts table because we want to add contacts to our audience inside of Mailchimp. So here you can see that I have created a separate column, which is called marketing list. And over here, we will say add to contact list. Inside of our Mailchimp, we need to create an audience. Usually you have one by default, but the next step would be to define what sort of fields you would like to have for your audience. Inside of settings, you can select edit fields and add any additional fields that you might need. Once ready, now we need to transfer all those contacts that are marked add to the list into the Mailchimp. You will see that we have filtered out all those contacts that need to be added to Mailchimp in a separate view. And we'll be using this view with the next tool, which is make.com. We'll be building a scenario on make.com that will start by watching this view inside of Airtable. So you can see that we are searching for the records inside of that specific view. And for all the records that we find, we will be adding them inside of our list. So you can see that we have mapped the first name to the first name, and we have also map the last name and the email address, and at the moment these are all the information. Once this is done, in the final step, we just update that the contact has been added to the list. So let's run this scenario once. For regular use, you can set this to run, for example, on a daily or every few hours schedule. Now you can see when we go back, here we can see that Luna has been added to our marketing list. And once we go to MailChimp, we can see now that Luna is inside of our marketing list and the source is Integromat, which is the old name of make.com. So you can see that the contact has been added. Once you have your audience set up, the next step for you would be to either schedule regular emails or to set up conditional emails based on the property, for example, last update or last contact date that has been synced here from Airtable. If you don't plan to send that many emails and also you don't care about them being fancy formatted, you can use Gmail and Google Workspace with limitation that there is a maximum number of messages, emails that you can send per day, which is 2000 for paid Google Workspace account and 500 for trial free accounts. So to do that, we'll be using a view similar to our SendGrid, but in this case, we have upgraded our email template. So once we go to the email template, you'll see that I have added the subject, that is a full subject that we'll be using on the email. And I have also added email body. In this case, this contains rich text formatting so that we are able to do some basic formatting inside of email, like headers, bullet points, or even links. Now going back to the view over here, once we set what sort of emails we want to send, the next thing would be to change the status to be sent. And in this case, we'll go to Airtable automations, and inside of automations, we will turn off our old automations for SendGrid, and then we will look at this new automation that is used for Gmail. You will see that this is built in a very similar way. It is reacting to the status to be sent, but what we do as a next step is we are looking up details of that specific template. So you will see that here we're looking up whether the related email fields on our email template contains the ID of the record that triggered that. And this will give us that specific template, which then we can reuse in the next step. So we can reuse it here from the find records, we can use the subject. And what we are doing over here, it's a slight customization that in the beginning we are saying dear and then the name of the person from the records, and then the email body comes from that specific template. And to be sure that this is looking the way we expect, we can click on the generate preview. And once we do the generate preview, we'll see to who that email will go. And we will also see the details of that specific email. If that is looking good, we can actually test it. And you can see that the emails are being sent out right now in this specific moment. And we can see inside of Gmail that the email have been sent up. It's the same email, but you will notice that the name of the person is changing and the email address is changing as well. And we kept also the basic formatting of that specific email over here, including the link. It is also possible to use exact same scenario, but instead of Gmail, to use Outlook. Let's talk about the case when you cannot use your Google Workspace or Outlook account and the emails that you're sending are just internal emails to your team, so you don't care too much how they look like. In this case, you can use the built-in native email, which is just available here under the send email button. So this is how you would add the email over here. And to do that, I'll go over here and turn off this scenario and move over to the scenario that I have prepared over here. It works exactly the same way. The difference is that here you are just using Airtable email, and the moment when you generate a preview, you will notice a few differences. First of all, it will arrive from Airtable automation email, and then it will be wrapped in a frame coming from Airtable. So that might not be a good choice for business emails to external contractors, but something internally that is pretty acceptable. So let's turn it on and test it. And it works the same way as the other scenario. So basically we select to be sent, the template, and drag and drop for example, the four records to which we would like to send the email to. You can see in the background, the automation is working. And now going to Airtable, I can see that I have received all those four emails. They're all address to me through different emails. So you can see that this is basically using the template from Airtable. There's still some basic formatting that makes it usable for a bit better formatting of the information and links and so on. But all of this is coming from Airtable. The limitation here is that you can use between 100 to 1000 unique email addresses per day, depending on your Airtable plan. So the use case here is definitely more usable, for example, to sending a link to Airtable, to internal collaborator within the company to make some changes or some updates. Now time for the final hack, which can be useful if you want to occasionally send emails to people, but you don't want to be copy-pasting their emails. So what we have created over here using Airtable formula is a Mailto link. The moment when you click on this Mailto link, it will open your local email client. And you can see that in my local Outlook window, I have already the two email prefilled, including the subject and the content of the email, which is coming from the template we have selected inside of Airtable. So this is something that you could now send directly from your Outlook on your local computer. To create that, we actually have added lookup columns for the subject and the email body coming from the template. And we are using those lookup columns inside of a template where we construct a mail to link that includes the email. And we're also including encoded subject and the body of the email together with the email over here. What is important, we are adding an empty space at the end of the lookup fields to convert them into regular text fields. So this is important in case you'll be trying to repeat that formula by yourself. And this way we get a link that can be used with any template that we select over here. I hope this was useful for you guys. Thank you very much for watching, and let us know if you found a method for sending emails that you like, and if not, what other ways of sending emails you would be interested in, and let us know your comments and questions that you have. Thank you so much for watching. Have a fantastic day ahead.